Ladies and gentlemen, Eddie Hearn's Matchroom Sport proudly presents 12 rounds of boxing, a final eliminator for the IBF Featherweight Championship of the World. Sponsored by 666bet, Scotch Menswear and StubHub. And we are live on Sky Sports. It's Fight Night Live! All the officials appointed by the IBF and the British Boxing Border Control. Supervisor from New York City, USA is Rob Scott, and our steward in charge and area representatives are Mick Collier, Bill Edwards and Des Reese. Inspectors working the red and blue corner are Harold Adams and Nigel Thomas. Timekeeper at the bell is Mr. Bob Edgeworth, and our medical officers, Dr. White, Dr. Buckland, Dr. O'Callaghan, and Dr. Sharma. Our three scoring judges, from Melbourne, Australia, Tony Marrott, from Leeds, England, Dave Paris, and from New York City, USA, Robin Taylor. When the bell rings and the action begins, the man in the middle, the man in charge, Marcus McDonald of Twickenham, England. And now, ladies and gentlemen, away we go, introducing to you. Fighting out of the red corner, wearing the green trunks trimmed with white, weighed in at 8 stone, 13 pounds, 6 ounces. Undefeated, 27 contests, 27 wins, 15 inside the scheduled distance. From Richmond, New South Wales, Australia, it's time to meet Aussie Joe Branca! Cross the ring, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the white trunks trimmed with gold, weighing in at 8 stone, 13 pounds, 10 ounces. 20 fight record, 19 wins, 7 inside the scheduled distance, and just one defeat. He comes to the ring as a former undefeated British, Commonwealth and European featherweight champion from Barry, South Wales, Lee Selby! Now, ladies and gentlemen, 12 rounds of final eliminator for the IBF Featherweight Championship of the World!
Guys, I spoke to you about the dressing room. Not expect outlaw professors all times. Obey my instructions. Watch your heads, keep it clean. Any questions? Let's go to work.
Both these fellas, in many ways, need a defining fight. Is this going to be the night for one of them? Lee Selby, British, Commonwealth, European belts all claimed. And closing in, he hopes, on a world title. Standing in his way, the unbeaten Aussie from New South Wales, Joel Branca. Here we go, scheduled for 12. Selby, the taller man. Branca in the green with the white trim. And you look at Branca on tape, Jim, as I'm sure you have. He doesn't have a reverse gear, does he?
No, and I think he's the kind of opponent that Lee Selby would be quite happy to face. And Selby's going to have to put some more snap into the punches than he's done in some of his recent fights. You know, he seems to defuse an opponent, get into control, but then doesn't put the pedal down. Well, I think this guy's going to be on his case every second. So I think he's going to have to find ways to discourage him, and good, solid punching is as good a way as any.
The two of them know each other a little bit. They sparred a couple of times in Las Vegas, once at the Mayweather gym.
See, I just wonder if Branca is clever enough or bring anything that Selby can't handle. He may just be a little bit straightforward in what he does, but he puts so much into it that he's difficult to contain. So Selby doing the right thing here, plenty of movement, getting his punches off, not allowing the early pressure to get to him.
And the punches are flowing together from Selby, and yeah, thank goodness there doesn't seem to be any damage to either man. Selby, I've said this before, Jim, a very physical featherweight, and you can see the size difference here. It's commanding look, and he puts 10 to 12 pounds on after the weigh-in. Big right hand coming in from Selby. Franca catching some early punishment here.
See, I think the fact that he marches straight forward is the perfect opponent for Selby. As long as Selby is 100% fit and firing on all cylinders, and we know that the people he has round him, that there's no way he's not going to be prepared for this fight, the biggest of his career so far. But you can see already how tough and brave the Aussie is.
Yeah, because Selby's been catching him with some good right hands, catching him with a left there as well. The only fighter that really put some heat on him was last summer. Selby faced the Romanian Viorel Simeon and faded badly in that fight and was happy to get out of it. We later heard that he had some hand damage. I think he broke a hand in that fight as well. So, as you say, if he stays healthy, he should be able to tame this fella, draw his sting. But it's going to take an awful lot to discourage Joel Brunker, who is durable and gritty.
See, Selby has shown in recent performances, he's okay, he showboats a little bit, but he enjoys showing his boxing skills. His two terrific performances against Stephen Smith, you know, and the little Scots kid. John Simpson, you thought he'd have wanted to build on that and score some knockouts, but from that point on, he just seems to like to settle down, show his skills, and he certainly did that in the opening round there.
Bronco, you would get the feeling, Jim, off the back of that first 3 minutes, might have to find a plan B here, because if that's plan A, it's not going to work.
Well, I always felt that maybe he didn't have enough about him. But, one round doesn't decide anything. You know, championship fights are over the 12-round distance for a reason. So we'll see if he can make his pressure work for him. I just don't think there's anything clever in what he does, nothing surprising. It's pretty straightforward, but if he's still doing this after six or seven rounds, then can he put a dent in Selby then? But it looks as though he's going to be outboxed in the early rounds.
Selby's swinging with that right hand, but caught on the glove by Brunker. And Selby out of range.
Selby not really bothered about power in his punches. He's quite happy with the movement and the accuracy. And over the 12-round distance, again, I think Selby probably sees this as a long fight. So pacing is important.
There are critics of Lee Selby out there, Jim, who say he does just enough. Are you one of those critics?
Well, I've phrased it differently. I said he always seems to have something in reserve. But, I mean, he's winning. He's winning. He's dominating, you know, at British and European level. He's moving on to world level. So I hope they're right. I hope they're right. He does have more to show us, because what he has shown us is pretty impressive.
Brunca looking to apply a bit of pressure, but he's struggling to land anything clean on Selby. Selby out of range a lot as well in this round. Selby looking to land the counters there as Brunca lunged in, and there's another nice combination. Right hand to the body, left hand upstairs. Couldn't follow it up though, Selby.
No, but I think Selby was about to follow it up when he saw that it hadn't really had much of an impact. But you can see he was ready to step in, then changed his mind. So I think if he does land something solidly, he will follow it up. He's lost his composure a little bit there, Selby, but no, this is fine so far from him.
It's not fine from Brunker. He's coming forward and he's trying to put some pressure on, but there's no end product or negligible end product for him. And there's the switch downstairs with that right hand from Selby, mixing it up nicely.
Not enough head movement from Brunker. There's virtually no head movement. He's marching straight forward. The first punch hits him, his head's still there when the second one comes. So
that's a bit better. And then Selby just manages to slip out of trouble. It's looking too easy in there for Lee Selby at the moment.
Selby's looking classy though. You know,
it really is.
The movement's good. Get it. The punches, the accuracy in the punches. Not looking for power. Just a little bit earlier though, when he thought he had clipped Brunker, he was ready to follow up, but another round on the bank.
Sport. The ultimate. Keep them tight, speed them up. That's the beginning. I'm going to ring off. I'm going to hit to the
Well, a happy, calm corner. And no reason to be otherwise.
Chickens out! Round three!
Tony Borg running the corner of Lee Selby. What a terrific job he does out of his Newport gym. Both with the pros and the amateurs. What a conveyor belt of talent coming off Tony's conveyor belt. And part of the team, of course, Chris and Jamie Senegal, who are the management team. Chris, the old pro, the old Southern Area champion. Very much involved in the corner as well. I'm talking about being involved in the corner. So, Gerald Brunker's cornermen were really giving him a mouthful while we were in a commercial break there. And it was John Barber doing the shouting, urging the big right hands over the top, which is a fine tactic, but he's got to land them. Telling off for use of the elbow there for Selby.
Well, nothing that Brunker has tried has worked, so he's going to have to be a bit more adventurous and be prepared to miss with punches. You know, I think he's trying to get close before he lets the punches go. He's going to have to punch on the way in. But you just wonder if whatever he does, if Selby won't just have an answer. This is better from him.
Yeah, Selby just in control of this one and cruising at the moment. Got through with the right hand there, but then took a left hook in return, Brunker, and did that shake him up a little bit? Selby's on him. I think that left, that counter left from Selby, shaken Brunker.
Yeah, but put him onto his heels there.
Big right hand following up. Brunker saw that one coming. He didn't see the left hook counter, though. I think he's recovered. He got him there, Selby, with a right uppercut. And just cruising along here, Lee Selby, and making this look really easy at the moment.
See, he's just so relaxed there. Selby, you know, although Brunker's coming forward, you can't really say he's pressurising Selby. Selby's working at a pace he's comfortable with. And, I mean, lovely, accurate punches.
I tell you, Jim, Selby is landing these left hands pretty much as he wants. Banging in a few right hands as well off the back. But Brunker's not seeing these lefts. He's not seeing the rights either.
You know, that was a beautiful punch, that. Knocked him on his heels. Just caught him a little bit square-footed. But I think it showed us how tough the Brunker was, because it's straight back in again. He won't be easily discouraged. But as expected, no surprises yet.
I remember talking to Tony Borg a few months ago, Jim, and we were talking about Lee and how easy he makes it all look sometimes. And I said, have we seen the best of him? He said, nowhere near. He said, he's levels more to show than we're seeing. And he's just making Joel Brunker look like an eight-round trier at the moment.
Well, I've always felt that he could do more. You know, he gets under control in a fight and then just kind of happy to stay there. Doesn't put the pedal down, as though he enjoys putting on a show. But if you want to pack arenas, then you want a little bit of drama. And I've always felt he's capable of it. So, should we have a word?
We live in a time of endless possibility.
Yep, another beautiful round of boxing from Selby. Did ship a couple of shots, which maybe give Brunker a little bit more confidence, but how nicely picked was that one? Straight onto the shot, and look at the look on Brunker's face.
Yeah, I think Brunker knows he's in deep here. I mean, the best win on his card came against a former flyweight champion, I think Ivan Hernandez, the WBO super flyweight champion, not light flyweight, excuse me, and Hernandez was 31 and on the slide at the time. He's never really had the big name, the big breakthrough win. He's got rid of who they put in front of him, but the more you look at this, the more you realise he's never been in with anyone of this level, and Selby catching him with a big right hand, and Brunker soaking it all up, but he's getting marked around the eyes now.
I mean, it's though he doesn't realise that he's just moved into range. He likes to get his feet close and let the punches go, but that's not working, so he's going to have to let the punches go a little bit earlier than he's doing. But as I said earlier, if he changes, I get the feeling so would Lee Selby. Just looking so comfortable.
Brunker, when he has landed cleanly, and it's been the odd clean shot, Selby doesn't seem to bother it at all, and they talk in the Tony Borg gym, I mean, the legendary stuff about how well he takes a punch. He's been hit by full-blown heavyweights. So he didn't go down. He also said he'd forgotten where he parked the car after that. But he takes a shot, Lee Selby. But that's another point, Jim. He doesn't have to take many, does he? When do you see Selby take full-blooded punches? His defences are really good.
Yeah, and his reflexes too. But this is what he enjoys. He enjoys putting on a boxing exhibition. And some of the people who complain about him, you know, they want to see more drama. They reckon he's capable of it. I do too. He punches harder than he's shown us so far. But a couple of times he's landed cleanly. You can see he's quite keen. I think he would quite like to make a statement here. And I think he would like the stoppage, so when he starts landing, you know, regularly, then we'll maybe see him put more spite into the punches.
Again, making Brunker miss horribly. Brunker just plodding forward, but every time he gets close, you just sense he's got into Selby's range. And the Welshman can pick him off as he wants like that. And they're talking animatedly in the corner.
I wonder if Selby will decide sooner or later that he wants to start taking it to Brunker. I mean, I really feel if he starts pushing Brunker back, he'll take everything away from him. This is a young man who has to be coming forward to do anything effectively. So I wonder if Lee Selby will start taking it to him, drive him back with a jab. No signs. He's just so happy. He's so comfortable at the moment. And a final eliminator, I might add.
Yeah, he's laughing, isn't he? Well, Anthony Joshua, the big fella, is due up next, the heavyweight. He smiles, he's relaxed. He's the coolest man on the planet. He really is. You wouldn't know he's in for a big fight tonight.
You ready? Anthony, a year on from your professional debut in the same arena, in the same dressing room. How do the feelings compare to that night?
It was a lot different. It was my pro debut. I was out of the ring for about 15 to 16 months, you know, making a decision to turn pro, training up for the pro debut. Now, I've been busy. I've been out 8 times this year. I'm feeling confident and relaxed, but I'm humble, I respect my opponent, I know he's dangerous, and I've got a tough job to do at hand in about an hour's time.
He's not been stopped since 2005. Do you think you can be the man to stop him tonight?
That's not really my main aim. My main aim is to go out there and do a job and get the win. There's a WBC international title on the line, and that's my main aim, is to win that. If the stoppage comes, that's a bonus, and that's a compliment of the training that I've been doing, my strength conditioning coach and my trainer in the gym. So we'll see what happens, but that's not the main aim. A knockout isn't. Good luck.
Thank you. Mr. Cool, he'll be on next as soon as Lee Selby has dealt with Joel Brunker, because that's what we're looking at, Jim. It's just a question of whether Selby can go through the gears, get this fella out of there, whether Brunker can stick around for 12 rounds, but certainly through the first four, it's been a gulf in class between the two in terms of talent and technique. Selby again just teeing off pretty much as he wants.
Bit more spite in those punches from Selby. I wonder maybe if he's thinking, I mean, really, stand your ground, don't allow this fellow to march forward. But the trouble, I think Lee enjoys what he's doing here. I think he actually enjoys putting on a boxing exhibition. You know, most boxing fans want the drama. He's capable of it. So I'm hoping sooner or later he'll stand his ground, take it to Brunker, and I wonder if he can get him out of there.
I think he's having a much easier night than he was expecting.
Step away. There you go. Step out.
Well, there he is. I mean, this is what happened against Randall Monroe. He was quite happy to box at a distance. Then a couple of times he pinned Randall in the corner, let the punches go. So first little signs
of
that.
Beautiful. He's took it very well, though, Brunker. Oh, just teed it up there, that sneaky right hand, and followed up with a hook.
You know, I'm just thinking, Nick, we're saying we want this, we want that. When Floyd Mayweather does stuff like this, we're raving about it. Well, that was pure class.
Well, they call him the Welsh Mayweather, don't they? You can see why. Caught him within a little counter there, and then just decided to hold. Again, that two-punch combination, that hook downstairs, the left hook upstairs.
The referee shouldn't allow him to place one hand on the opponent before while he tees up the other one. But I think Marco Mizuno's just letting things flow, which is good. But there are times when he actually lays the leading hand on Brunker, then throws the right.
Well, he boxed the WBC eliminator, didn't he, last time we saw him against that Mexican, Carcicha, who didn't offer an awful lot and didn't have a lot on his card. You were wondering what he was doing, quite frankly, in the eliminator. Brunker deserves his shot. But Selby is making him look very ordinary indeed.
Greg, stop boxing! Step away, don't you?
I'm just wondering what they tell the Brunker when he goes back to the corner. I don't fancy the job because I wouldn't know what to tell him.
Well, I said at the end of the first round, Jim, he needs a plan B. He ain't got one.
No. Sport.
Saying you've got to throw more punches. I mean, yeah. Also that.
So, what you got to miss with more punches, I think that's the result of that. The kid is simply not good enough. Selby is class. He is looking genuine, world class. Brunker has never been anyone in with anyone as good as this.
Round six then, it is a 12-rounder. Selby not yet out of second gear. I'm not even asking you for your card, Jim. That's redundant.
See, Selby is also so slick defensively. It must be so frustrating for Brunker. I mean, fighters, I think they know as they move up in class there's a chance they can lose a fight, but they don't believe they'll find themselves in with someone they can't even hit with a clean punch.
Oh, he's getting schooled, isn't he, Brunker?
Totally.
Taken to the cleaners here. And then they're screaming in Brunker's corner, work, work.
I mean, they're right, he has to raise the tempo, but how long can he do that? Selby looks naturally bigger as well. But, I mean, he's giving it a go in this round, Brunker.
Well, I don't even want to criticise him, because he's giving it a go and he's doing the best he can here, Brunker. He's just not in Selby's class. It's as simple as that.
See, this is the point where I felt he might bring out the best in Selby, and this is where I feel Selby should dig the punches in. Discourage this fellow. This fellow needs a big round. He's
right
going
hand
good work
comes
here from
in
him.
From Brunker. A rare success for Joel Brunker there. The pressure from the Aussie is relentless. But it's coming at a cost as well.
But we're only reaching the halfway stage, and if nothing else, he's made an impression in this round. He's raised the tempo, so this is the point where Selby has to show the power in his punches as well as the class in his boxing. No, he needs more snap in his punches, Selby.
Well, if Brunker can keep this going for the rest of the fight, you never know, maybe it might get interesting. But that's the second time he's been caught with that uppercut in this round here, Brunker, who does take a shot. And Selby just eluding him. It's like watching a man trying to swat a wasp, isn't it? He's just swinging and missing and keeping on coming. And Selby just back out of range again.
Well, he had some success in this round, Brunker, so maybe his corner can find a reason to get him pumped up a little bit there. But again, outboxed for most of the round.
Up those right hands, can't they just plant the feet, launch them, telegraph them, and they still land from Selby. But Brunker's been on his case every second of that round. And I don't think Selby was troubled one little bit, quite frankly. Tony Ball doesn't exactly look a man under pressure here, does he?
Well, at least Brunker had some success in that round, got some punches home. But he probably used up a lot of steam in doing so, and we didn't see him come up with anything as classy as that uppercut from Selby. But I really feel Selby should stand his ground a little bit more and meet this fellow, try to get him back onto the back foot. I'm sure he has the power to do that.
Yeah, Tony Borg there, no hooks, just go for straight shots. And with a guy that doesn't have an awful lot of upper body movement, as you've already said, Jim, very little head movement from Brunker, the straight shots can't miss.
Well, he's on the march at least, Brunker. We didn't expect he would give up easily. And he's having to prove that now, which he's doing.
Well, he's tough and he's giving it a go. Biggest fight of his career, don't forget. Left hand comes in once again from Selby. Who again can just turn Brunker. It seems physically he can just do what he wants with Brunker in there.
I wonder if he could push him back. I wonder if it's possible to get Brunker onto the back foot. I wonder if Selby can do that. Oh, lovely right hand. Yes, I mean, it's beautiful boxing.
It really is. It really is. The irony is, if he doesn't get this fellow out of there, he's probably going to get some criticism tonight, because he didn't stop him. Brunker trying to think his way in. Selby too cute again.
I mean, he really has no defence whatsoever, Brunker. All he's thinking about is how to get his punches home, just disregarding what's coming back at him. Nice little burst there from Selby.
Well, Brunker put a lot of pressure on in the last round. Jim, would you enough to give him a share of the round on your card?
No, I don't think so. You know, a couple of bits of success, but he took too many in the process. Maybe the judges looking for an excuse to be kind to him. But the thing is, I mean, he's looking as strong now. There's the right hand again from Brunker. He's looking as strong now. So is it a problem that Selby's not knocking anything out of his tank?
Well, it is going to raise questions that have been asked before. Does Selby have real power at the elite level?
Selby not quite as smooth in this round as he's been earlier. Is that a sign? You know, is that a sign that the pressure is beginning to pester him at least?
Well, and the pressure is still coming. Brunker is just plodding away gamely. Well, again, I'll go back to Selby and his power. I mean, when he took out Stephen Smith, nobody's done that. When he, time out, I think the mouthpiece has come out, but when he took out Stephen Smith and when he followed that up, becoming the first man ever to stop tough John Simpson, everyone thought, well, Selby, what a dig he's got, but he's never really followed it up. He went through the motions against Martin Lindsay, who is a real tough and durable type, won every round comfortably, never really threatened to put Martin away.
Well, I mean, there's no denying that Brunker is doing better the last couple of rounds. Whether he's doing good enough to win rounds is another story. But if one of them is improving, it's Brunker. He's getting closer, he's getting some punches home. Not enough, probably.
It's still Selby that's looking the more relaxed as he goes back to the corner.
Well,
those stats, if they're true, are damning. And they don't reflect the effort that Joel Brunker has put into this. You cannot fault this man's courage and his guts.
Well, I've given Selby every round, having said that Brunker has improved a little bit in the last couple of rounds. Not been able to string anything together. Selby just too slick for him. So I wonder if it'll be more of the same in the Selby corner, or if he'll maybe want him to put a bit more spite into his punches, short, straight punches.
Back to the power of Lee Selby. His last stoppage was against Rendell Monroe, and two questions there. Was Rendell a featherweight, and also Rendell right at the end of his career, pretty much. He was retired by Josh Warrington in his next fight. But before that, he'd had the Simeon fight against Coasicha last time out, who was nothing special, a totally forgettable fight. He never threatened to put him down. And here he is, more of the same with Joel Bronco. He's got the skills, has he got the spite?
Well, certainly he's not looking as smooth as he was earlier. Bronco's certainly more of a pest at the moment, but not really landing anything cleanly. Got one there, Bronco.
Nice left hook counter to the body from Selby. Bronco stays on his case. You can hear just the hum and the buzz from the crowd. It's like they've... I mean, they're thinking, well, you know, we saw all this in the last round and the round before that.
See, I don't think Lee realises that. That's what I've been on his case the last few fights. He needs to inject a little bit more into what, you know, brilliant boxing. Okay, but 12 rounds is a long time if it becomes repetitious.
Yeah, lovely work from Selby, that body combination just thudding home. There was the shot upstairs as Bronco's defences continue to not really impress. I mean, he's wide open to these body shots and has been from first bell, Bronco, but still he keeps coming.
That's better from Selby. You'd like to see him landing a punch like that and then following up on it. I think he's happy with the way things are going. So he's leaving well alone. I mean, it's quite possible that Bronco just, you know, Selby doesn't have the power to hurt this fellow. I mean, he's catching him cleanly. These are good punches in this round from Selby. He's winding them up, he's digging them in.
It's just effortless from Selby, isn't it? It's just so comfortable.
Oh, that's a good right hand.
Really solid right hand.
The
Bronco's absorbed it all.
He's walking right after him. No, so maybe Lee Selby's doing the right thing here. This is going 12 rounds like a lumpet, so just make sure he wins most of them.
Well, I know how you're seeing it, Jim, and I'm not disagreeing with a word of it. It's a complete shutout from Lee Selby, but Spencer Oliver is an extra pair of eyes at ringside. He's with Ed, and let's find out how Spence is seeing it.
Well, beautiful skills from Lee Selby. Have you given him everything so far?
Yeah, I've got Selby winning everything. This is the best I've seen him for a long time. For me, it's punch perfect, moving beautifully. Bronco, very tough, trying to force the pace. But Selby, for me, at the moment, winning everything.
Nick and Jim seem to think that maybe Selby should try and force a stoppage, just step it up. Do you think he's doing everything he can?
Yeah, I think he's boxing the right fight at the moment. For me, you know, I think he should just stick to his boxing skills. He's landing that right hand perfectly. If anything, he's going a little bit wild with the left hook, going a bit long with the left hook. But for me, it's a punch-perfect performance. I don't think he should try and stand there with Bronco. Bronco, that's his game. We've seen him before. We've seen him a number of occasions. He likes to come forward, throw punches in bunches, but Selby's not allowing him to do that. So for me, boxing perfect at the moment. He should just stick to what he's doing.
Thank you, Spencer.
Second out, round nine.
Punch-perfect from Spencer Oliver, who, like both of us, think Lee Selby has every single round of this in the bank.
Yep, you know, I agree with everything that Spencer said there. It is perfect, and it's an important fight. The final eliminator, the main thing is you win it. But you want promoters knocking on your door as well. I mean, that's what makes the big fights. That's what makes the stadium fights, the excitement, the fights the fans want to see. I'm just wondering if Lee needs to give us a little bit more to get into that league. But the main thing, first of all, is a world title. Then maybe you can start thinking about the icing on the cake. But, I mean, as Spencer says, you cannot fault what he's doing
here.
No,
you really can't. And he's digging in some body shots here in this ninth round as well. And Bronco is just taking everything and coming back for more. I mean, in terms of technique, you know, the boxing purist is absolutely loving this. But I'll go back to what I said earlier, Jim. Listen to this crowd. There's not a sound, not a murmur.
Yeah, and a couple of times when he has let punches go, you know, he lifts them immediately. They just, that's what they want to see. It's entertainment. I mean, the boxing is beautiful. You can't fault anything. I mean, this is a guy who's rated higher than he is in the IBF ratings. And you know, he's completely outboxing him, taking him to school. So if he's happy, if his camper happy, then maybe we should leave it alone.
Exactly, and Tony Ball's right. I think this guy could just find levels. Just keep finding levels.
We need to see him in a situation like where he's struggling to win a fight.
Yep.
Then maybe he'll bring out the stuff that we're asking for.
Little burst there from Brunker, but he was immediately punished for it.
But there you go, he's got him on the back foot. This is what I've been waiting to see. To see what he can do. The body weight forward, more power in the punches, see if he can put a dent in this fella now.
Oh, and
this
is a spot in the body shot there, that left to the body. And this might be the exclamation mark we've been looking for Lee Selby. That left hook to the body has really hurt Brunker, who's backing up here and digging deep. Selby looking to place the punches rather than going hell for leather. And Brunker able to breathe again. But can he stay off the hook here? He was really suffering as that left went in. And Selby's looked for it again. And Brunker, clever enough to just bring the elbow down. But he's getting banged around this ring now. And the crowd really is into it.
Well, I think what I've been saying, Nick is fully justified. And he's showing us that. I've asked him to put it onto the front foot. Drive this fella back. And what a change in the fight. This is terrific stuff from Lee Selby.
He's destroying him. And that'll do it, surely, yes. He just broke him on systematically at the end. We said we needed a bit of razzle-dazzle. We got it. A brave, determined Australian was just sliced up in that round. And that man is going on to a world title shot next.
That is exactly the kind of performance you want to take towards a world title fight. Perfect, I agree with Spencer, perfect. But that was more than perfect, because that was all I was missing was the drama. I always feel, you should, if you're winning every single round of a 12-rounder, really, the referee should be stepping in. You know, if you're dominating a fight, the guy shouldn't hear the final bell. There were signs that Brunker was going to hear the final bell. Then one big punch landed, Selby followed it up, and what he produced from that point on was nothing short of terrific. Fantastic punching. And you just knew the end was in sight. Nothing that the Brunker could do about it. The body shot, just look at the face, took everything away from him. Then we saw the Lee Selby that we've been waiting to see. We know it's there, I've always felt it's there, and that's what brings the crowd back. You know, people at Frampton and Quigg, they want to get opponents out of there. Lee Selby has to get that into his way of thinking. This is terrific. And you heard you talked about the crowd, Nick. You heard the crowd when this was going on. Tremendous.
Yeah, right back into it. And Selby showing a nasty, ruthless streak in there to get this fella out of there. They were hurtful, accurate punches. Once he got him shaken up, he didn't let him off the hook. And look at that. The swagger man is back. A lot to like about this performance. We were crying out for the grandstand finish. We got it. Selby moves onwards to Evgeny Granovic next. And just look at what it means to Tony Borg and the team.
Ladies and gentlemen, timekeeper Bob Edgeworth has recorded a time of 2:49 of the ninth round. Referee Marcus McDonald has stopped this contest with Brunker in no position to continue. Therefore, your winner of this final eliminator for the IBF Featherweight Championship of the World, Lee Selby!
He just went to another level, and the three cards, incidentally, two of them 80-72, 179-73. Selby was comfortably in control. So we'll hear from Lee in a minute, but that's our next fight. Anthony Joshua coming up against Dennis Baktov, who has a reputation for durability. It's Joshua's first step up into 10-round territory. He's never been past three before. He can punch holes in walls as well if he wants to. That's next. But Lee Selby, big night for him. As we said earlier, the connoisseurs would have loved it, and the public would have loved the way he finished. An absolute flourish from Lee Selby, and he's ready to move on to the biggest stage of all.
Lee, the biggest test of your career, did it bring out the best of you?
No, I don't think so. There's still a very lot more to come. As soon as I can bring my spider and my gym work into the ring, you'll see a true champion who can mix with any featherweight.
So what was wrong with that performance?
It was good, but if you come down to the gym and see me spy, you'd be shocked, honestly.
But Joel Bronco arrived with a good reputation, unbeaten 27 fights before this evening. That was supposed to be your big test, and you barely got hit in there.
That's it. I passed to a flying colours, and I'll do exactly the same to Evgeny Gradovich. I think that was just as tough as the fight with Gradovich would be.
And for the first time in a while, we saw you really step up the pace when you had to in the ninth round, not just drifting through to win on points. Were you aware you needed to make a statement and show you could stop these kind of guys?
Yeah, I've had quite a bit of criticism by a few people, so I thought I'd put on a bit of a show tonight.
Justified criticism?
Partly, but I've been guilty of just coasting for my fights. I'm finding it so easy. I'm just doing enough to get the job done, to win. But this is a final eliminator for the world title. I had to prove that I'm worthy to challenge for the world title.
Manager Chris Senegal, you were a bit nervous beforehand, weren't you? Because it was a good test on paper.
Yeah, it was a big test on paper. But, you know, Lee Selby boxed orders, just like he's boxed the orders in his last couple of fights. Getting the rounds under the belt, learning how to box, and now we've seen it.
Let's have a word with promoter Eddie Hearn. What are the chances of getting Evgeny Gradovich over here to defend his world title?
Well, look, he boxes all over the world, so, you know, why not? He boxes in November, and then Lee Selby's up next. Faultless performance. You know, such a quality fighter, and so good to get the stoppage. You know, he coasts through these rounds. I can't remember the last time I saw him lose a round. And to get him out of there in style was very, very impressive. Full credit to Brunker. What a tough man, 27-0. That was Lee Selby's acid test. He's just cruised through it. He's ready to become a world champion. I believe he'll beat Gradovich, and we'll get that done in the spring next year.
How confident are you of becoming world champion next year?
100%. I'm confident going into every fight. Like I said, in the gym, I feel in myself, I'm brilliant. Honestly, in the gym, I'm brilliant. As soon as I can bring back to the fight, I won't be getting stopped.
Well done tonight.
Thank you.
We've heard it from the horse's mouth, confident that he'll be walking into a world title situation. Sparring.
In gear. I'm not even asking you for your card, Jim. That's redundant.
See, Selby is also so slick defensively. That must be so frustrating for Brunca. I mean, fighters, I think they know as they move up in class, there's a chance they can lose a fight. But they don't believe they'll find themselves in with someone they can't even hit with a clean punch.
Oh, he's getting schooled, isn't he, Bronco?
Totally.
Taken to the cleaners here. And then they're screaming in Bronco's corner, work, work.
I mean, they're right, he has to raise the tempo, but how long can he do that? Selby looks naturally bigger as well. But, he's giving it a go in this round, Bronca.
Well, I don't even want to criticise him because he's giving it a go and he's doing the best he can here, Bronca. He's just not in Selby's class. Simple as that.
See, this is the point where I felt he might bring out the best in Selby, and this is where I feel Selby should dig the punches in. Discourage this fellow. This fellow needs a big round. He's
right
going
hand
good work
comes
here from
in
him.
From Bronca. A rare success for Joel Brunker there. The pressure from the Aussie is relentless. But it's coming at a cost as well.
But we're only reaching the halfway stage, and if nothing else, he's made an impression in this round. He's raised the tempo, so this is the point where Selby has to show the power in his punches, as well as the class in his boxing. He needs more snap in his punches, Selby.
Well, if Bronco can keep this going for the rest of the fight, you never know, maybe it might get interesting. But that's the second time he's been caught with that uppercut in this round here, Bronco, who does take a shot. And Selby just eluding him. It's like watching a man trying to swat a wasp, isn't it? He's just swinging and missing and keeping on coming. And Selby just back out of range again.
Well, he had some success in this round, Brunker, so maybe his corner can find a reason to get him pumped up a little bit there. But again, outboxed for most of the round.
Tee up those right hands, can't he just plant the feet launch them, telegraph them, and they still land from Selby. But Brunk has been on his case every second of that round. And I don't think Selby was troubled one little bit, quite frankly. Tony Ball doesn't exactly look a man under pressure here, does he?
Well, at least Brunker had some success in that round, got some punches home. But he probably used up a lot of steam in doing so, and we didn't see him come up with anything as classy as that uppercut from Selby. But I really feel Selby should stand his ground a little bit more and meet this fellow, try to get him back onto the back foot. I'm sure he has the power to do that.
No rush. Oh. What's working, mate? It's a fast combination. Straight shot, no hooks. Straight shot and then nail him.
Yeah, let's get up. Yeah, Tony Borg there. No hooks, just go for straight shots.
Round seven.
And with a guy that doesn't have an awful lot of upper body movement, and as you've already said, Jim, very little head movement from Brunker, the straight shots can't miss.
Well, he's on the march at least, Brunker. We didn't expect he would give up easily. And he's having to prove that now, which he's doing.
Well, he's tough and he's giving it a go. Biggest fight of his career, don't forget. Left hand comes in once again from Selby. Who again can just turn Brunker. It seems physically he can just do what he wants with Brunker in there.
I wonder if he could push him back. I wonder if it's possible to get Brunker onto the back foot. I wonder if Selby can do that. Oh, lovely right hand. Yes, I mean, it's beautiful boxing.
It really is.
Selby.
It really is. The irony is, if he doesn't get this fella out of there, he's probably going to get some criticism tonight, because he didn't stop him. Bronco trying to think his way in. Selby too cute again.
I mean, he really has no defence whatsoever, Brunker. All he's thinking about is how to get his punches home, just disregarding what's coming back at him. Nice little burst there from Selby.
Well, Brunker put a lot of pressure on in the last round. Jim, would you enough to give you a share, give him a share of the round on your card?
No, I don't think so. You know, a couple of bits of success, but he took too many in the process. Maybe the judge is looking for an excuse to be kind to him. But the thing is, I mean, he's looking as strong now. There's the right hand again from Brunker. He's looking as strong now. So is it a problem that Selby's not knocking anything out of his tank?
It is going to raise questions that have been asked before. Does Selby have real power at the elite level?
Selby not quite as smooth in this round as he's been earlier. Is that a sign? You know, is that a sign that the pressure, you know, is beginning to pester him at least?
Well, and the pressure is still coming. Brunker is just plodding away gamely. Again, I'll go back to Selby and his power. I mean, when he took out Stephen Smith, nobody done that. When he time out, I think the mouthpiece has come out, but when he took out Stephen Smith and when he followed that up becoming the first man ever to stop tough John Simpson, everyone thought, well, Selby, what a dig he's got. But he's never really followed it up. He went through the motions against Martin Lindsay, who is a real tough and durable type, won every round comfortably, never really threatened to put Martin away.
Well, I mean, there's no denying that Brunker is doing better the last couple of rounds. Whether he's doing good enough to win rounds is another story. But if one of them is improving, it's Brunker. He's getting closer, he's getting some punches home. Not enough, probably. I just don't think there's anything clever in what he does, nothing surprising. It's pretty straightforward, but if he's still doing this after six or seven rounds, then can he put a dent in Selby then? But it looks as though he's going to be outboxed in the early rounds.
Selby's swinging with that right hand, but caught on the glove by Brunker. And Selby out of range.
Selby not really bothered about power in his punches. He's quite happy with the movement and the accuracy. and over the 12 round distance. Again, I think Selby probably sees this as a long fight, so pacing is important.
There are critics of Lee Selby out there, Jim, who say he does just enough. Are you one of those critics?
Well, I've phrased it differently. I said he always seems to have something in reserve. But, I mean, he's winning. He's winning. He's dominating, you know, at British and European level. He's moving on to world level. So I hope they're right. I hope they're right. He does have more to show us, because what he has shown us is pretty impressive.
Bronco looking to apply a bit of pressure, but he's struggling to land anything clean on Selby. Selby out of range a lot as well in this round. Selby looking to land the counters there as Bronco lunged in, and there's another nice combination. Right hand to the body, left hand upstairs. Couldn't follow it up though, Selby.
No, but I think Selby was about to follow it up when he saw that it hadn't really had much of an impact. But you can see he was ready to step in, then changed his mind. So I think if it does land something solidly, he will follow it up. He's lost his composure a little bit there, Selby, but no, this is fine so far from him.
It's not fine from Bronco. He's coming forward and he's trying to put some pressure on, but there's no end product or negligible end product for him. And there's the switch downstairs with that right hand from Selby, mixing it up nicely.
There's not... I was going to say not enough head movement for Bronco. There's virtually no head movement. He's marching straight forward. The first punch hits him. His head's still there when the second one comes. So
that's a bit better. And then Selby just manages to slip out of trouble. It's looking too easy in there for Lee Selby at the moment.
Selby's looking classy, though. You know,
it really is.
The movement's good. The punches, the accuracy in the punches. Not looking for power. Just a little bit earlier than when he thought he had clipped Bronco. He was ready to follow up, but another round in the bank.
Sport, the ultimate.
Well, a happy, calm corner, and no reason to be otherwise.
Checkers out. Round three.
Tony Borg running the corner of Lee Selby. What a terrific job he does out of his Newport gym, both with the pros and the amateurs. What a conveyor belt of talent coming off Tony's conveyor belt. And part of the team, of course, Chris and Jamie Senegal, who are the management team. Chris, the old pro, the old Southern Area champion, very much involved in the corner as well. I'm talking about being involved in the corner. So, Joel Bronco's cornermen were really giving him a mouthful while we were in a commercial break there. It was John Barber doing the shouting, urging the big right hands over the top, which is a fine tactic, but he's got to land them. Telling off for use of the elbow there for Selby.
Well, nothing that Bronco has tried has worked, so he's going to have to be a bit more adventurous and be prepared to miss with punches. You know, I think he's trying to get close before he lets the punches go. He's going to have to punch on the way in. But you just wonder if whatever he does, if Selby won't just have an answer. This is better from him.
Yeah, Selby just in control of this one and cruising at the moment. Got through with a right hand there, but then took a left hook in return, Bronco, and did that shake him up a little bit? Selby's on him. I think that counter left from Selby, shaken Bronco.
Yeah, but put him onto his heels there.
Big right hand following up. Right hand. Bronco saw that one coming. He didn't see the left hook counter, though. I think he's recovered. He got in there, Selby, with a right uppercut. And just cruising along here, Lee Selby, and making this look really easy at the moment.
See, he's just so relaxed, Selby. You know, although Bronco's coming forward, you can't really see he's pressurising Selby. Selby's working at a pace he's comfortable with. And, I mean, lovely, accurate punches.
Tell you, Jim, Selby is landing these left hands pretty much as he wants. Banging in a few right hands as well off the back. But Bronco's not seen these lefts. He's not seen the rights either.
You know, that was a beautiful punch. Oh, that knocked him on his heels. Just caught him a little bit square-footed. But I think it showed us how tough that Bronco was, because it's straight back in again. He won't be easily discouraged. But as expected, no surprises yet.
remember talking to Tony Borg a few months ago, Jim, and we were talking about Lee and how easy he makes it all look sometimes. And I said, have we seen the best of him? He said, nowhere near. He said, he's levels more to show than we're seeing. And he's just making Joel Brunker look like an eight-round trier at the moment.
Well, I've always felt that he could do more. You know, he gets under control in a fight and then just kind of happy to stay there. Doesn't put the pedal down as though he enjoys putting on a show. But if you want to pack arenas, then you want a little bit of drama. And I've always feel he's capable of it. So, should we have a word?
We live in a time of endless possibility.
Yep, another beautiful round of boxing from Selby. Did ship a couple of shots, which maybe give Brunker a little bit more confidence, but how nicely picked was that one? Straight onto the shot, and look at the look on Brunker's face.
Yeah, I think Brunker knows he's in deep here. I mean, the best win on his card came against a former flyweight champion, I think Ivan Hernandez, the WBO super flyweight champion, not light flyweight, excuse me, and Hernandez was 31 and on the slide at the time. He's never really had the big name, the big breakthrough win. He's got rid of who they put in front of him, but the more you look at this, the more you realise he's never been in with anyone.
Ladies and gentlemen, Eddie Hearn's Matchroom Sport proudly presents 12 rounds of boxing, a final eliminator for the IBF Featherweight Championship of the World. Sponsored by 666 Bet, Scotch Menswear and StubHub. And we are live on Sky Sports. It's Fight Night Live!
All the officials appointed by the IBF and the British Boxing Board of Control. Supervisor from New York City, USA is Rob Scott, and our steward in charge and area representatives are Mick Collier, Bill Edwards and Des Rees. Inspectors working the red and blue corner are Harold Adams and Nigel Thomas. Timekeeper at the bell is Mr. Bob Edgeworth, and our medical officers, Dr. White, Dr. Buckland, Dr. O'Callaghan, and Dr. Sharma. Our three scoring judges, from Melbourne, Australia, Tony Marrott, from Leeds, England, Dave Paris, and from New York City, USA, Robin Taylor. When the bell rings and the action begins, the man in the middle, the man in charge, Marcus McDonald of Twickenham, England. And now, ladies and gentlemen, away we go, introducing to you. Fighting out of the red corner, wearing the green trunks trimmed with white, weighed in at 8 stone, 13 pounds, 6 ounces. Undefeated, 27 contests, 27 wins, 15 inside the scheduled distance. From Richmond, New South Wales, Australia, it's time to meet Aussie Joe Brunker! Cross the ring, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the white trunks trimmed with gold, weighing in at 8 stone, 13 pounds, 10 ounces. 20 fight record, 19 wins, 7 inside the scheduled distance, and just one defeat. He comes to the ring as a former undefeated British, Commonwealth and European featherweight champion from Bury, South Wales, Lee Selby! Now, ladies and gentlemen, 12 rounds of final eliminator for the IBF Featherweight Championship of the World!
I spoke to you about in the dressing room, not expect out of professors all times, obey my instructions, watch your heads, keep it clean. Any questions? Let's go to work.
Both these fellas in many ways need a defining fight. Is this going to be the night for one of them? Lee Selby, British, Commonwealth, European belts all claimed. And closing in, he hopes, on a world title, standing in his way the unbeaten Aussie from New South Wales, Joel Bronca. Here we go, scheduled for 12. Selby, the taller man. Bronca in the green with the white trim. And you look at Bronca on tape, Jim, as I'm sure you have. He doesn't have a reverse gear, does he?
No, and I think he's the kind of opponent that Elise Selby would be quite happy to face. And Selby's going to have to put some more snap into the punches than he's done in some of his recent fights. You know, he seems to defuse an opponent, get into control, but then doesn't put the pedal down. Well, I think this guy's going to be on his case every second. So I think he's going to have to find ways to discourage him, and good, solid punching is as good a way as any.
The two of them know each other a little bit. They sparred a couple of times in Las Vegas, once at the Mayweather gym.
See, I just wonder if Bronca is clever enough or bring anything that Selby can't handle. He may just be a little bit straightforward in what he does, but he puts so much into it that he's difficult to contain. So Selby doing the right thing here, plenty of movement, getting his punches off, not allowing the early pressure to get to him.
And the punches are flowing together from Selby, and yeah, thank goodness there doesn't seem to be any damage to either man. Selby, I've said this before, Jim, a very physical featherweight, and you can see the size difference here. It's commanding, look, and he puts 10 to 12 pounds on after the weigh. Big right hand coming in from Selby. Bronca catching some early punishment here.
See, I think the fact that he marches straight forward is the perfect opponent for Selby. As long as Selby is 100% fit and firing in all cylinders, and we know that the people he has around him, that there's no way he's not going to be prepared for this fight, the biggest of his career so far. But you can see already how tough and brave the Aussie is.
Yeah, because Selby's been catching him with some good right hands, catching him with a left there as well. The only fighter that really put some heat on him was last summer. Selby faced the Romanian Viorel Simeon and faded badly in that fight and was happy to get out of it. We later heard that he had some hand damage. I think he broke a hand in that fight as well. So, as you say, if he stays healthy, he should be able to tame this fella, draw his sting, but it's going to take an awful lot to discourage Joel Bronca, who is durable and gritty.
See, Selby has shown in recent performances, okay, he showboats a little bit, but he enjoys showing his boxing skills. His two terrific performances against Stephen Smith, you know, and the little Scots kid. John Simpson, you thought he'd have wanted to build on that and score some knockouts, but from that point on, he just seems to like to settle down, show his skills, and he certainly did that in the opening round there.
Bronca, you would get the feeling, Jim, off the back of that first 3 minutes, might have to find a plan B here, because if that's plan A, it's not going to work.
Well, I always felt that maybe he didn't have enough about him. But, I mean, one round doesn't decide anything. You know, championship fights are over a 12-round distance for a reason. So we'll see if he can make his pressure work for him.
It's still Selby that's looking the more relaxed as he goes back to the corner. Those stats, if they're true, are damning. And they don't reflect the effort that Joel Bronca has put into this. You cannot fault this man's courage and his guts.
Well, I've given Selby every round, having said that Bronca has improved a little bit in the last couple of rounds. Not been able to string anything together. Selby just too slick for him. So I wonder if it'll be more of the same in the Selby corner, or if they'll maybe want him to put a bit more spite into his punches, short, straight punches.
Back to the power of Lee Selby. His last stoppage was against Rendell Monroe, and two questions there. Was Rendell a featherweight, and also Rendell right at the end of his career pretty much? He was retired by Josh Warrington in his next fight. But before that, he'd had the Simeon fight against Koa Secha last time out, who was nothing special, a totally forgettable fight. He never threatened to put him down. And here he is, more of the same with Joel Brunker. He's got the skills, has he got the spite?
Well, certainly he's not looking as smooth as he was earlier. Brunker's certainly more of a pest at the moment, but not really landing anything cleanly. Got one there, Brunker.
Nice left hook counter to the body from Selby. Brunker stays on his case. You can hear just the hum and the buzz from the crowd. It's like they've... I mean, they're thinking, well, you know, we saw all this in the last round and the round before that.
See, I don't think Lee realises that. I mean, that's what I've been on his case the last few fights. He needs to inject a little bit more into what, you know, brilliant boxing. Okay, but 12 rounds is a long time if it becomes repetitious.
Yeah, lovely work from Selby, that body combination just thudding home. There was the shot upstairs as Brunker's defences continue to not really impress. I mean, he's wide open to these body shots and has been from first bell, Brunker, but still he keeps coming.
That's better from Selby. You'd like to see him landing a punch like that and then following up on it. I think he's happy with the way things are going. So he's leaving well alone. I mean, it's quite possible that Brunker just, you know, Selby doesn't have the power to hurt this fellow. I mean, he's catching him cleanly. These are good punches in this round from Selby. He's winding them up, he's digging them in.
It's just effortless from Selby, isn't it? It's just so comfortable.
Oh, that's a good right hand.
Really solid right hand. The young Brunker's absorbed it all.
He's walking right after him. So maybe Lee Selby's doing the right thing here. This is going 12 rounds like a lumpet, so just make sure he wins most of them.
Well, I know how you're seeing it, Jim, and I'm not disagreeing with a word of it. It's a complete shutout from Lee Selby, but Spencer Oliver is an extra pair of eyes at ringside. He's with Ed, and let's find out how Spencer's seeing it.
Well, beautiful skills from Lee Selby. Have you given him everything so far?
Yeah, I've got Selby winning everything. This is the best I've seen him for a long time. For me, it's punch perfect, moving beautifully. Brunker, very tough, trying to force the pace. But Selby, for me, at the moment, winning everything.
Nick and Jim seem to think that maybe Selby should try and force the stoppages, step it up. Do you think he's doing everything he can?
Yeah, I think he's boxing the right fight at the moment. For me, you know, I think he should just stick to his boxing skills. He's landing that right hand perfectly. If anything, he's going a little bit wild with the left hook, going a bit long with the left hook. But for me, it's a punch-perfect performance. I don't think he should try and stand there with Brunker. Brunker, that's his game. We've seen him before. We've seen him a number of occasions. He likes to come forward, throw punches in bunches, but Selby's not allowing him to do that. So for me, boxing perfect at the moment. He should just stick to what he's doing.
Thank you, Spencer.
Second out, round 9.
Round 9. Punch-perfect from Spencer Oliver, who, like both of us, think Lee Selby has every single round of this in the bank.
Yep, you know, I agree with everything that Spencer said there. It is perfect, and that's an important fight. The final eliminator, the main thing is you win it. But you want promoters knocking on your door as well. I mean, that's what makes the big fights. That's what makes the stadium fights, the excitement, the fights the fans want to see. I'm just wondering if Lee needs to give us a little bit more to get into that league. But the main thing, first of all, is a world title. Then maybe you can start thinking about the icing on the cake. But, I mean, as Spencer says, you cannot fault what he's doing
here.
No,
you really can't. And he's digging in some body shots here in this ninth round as well. And Brunker is just taking everything and coming back for more. I mean, in terms of technique, you know, the boxing purist is absolutely loving this. But I'll go back to what I said earlier, Jim. Listen to this crowd. There's not a sound, not a murmur.
Yeah, and a couple of times when he has let punches go, you know, he lifts them immediately. They just that's what they want to see. It's entertainment. I mean, the boxing is beautiful. You can't fault anything. I mean, this is a guy who's rated higher than he is in the IBF ratings. And, you know, he's completely outboxing him, taking him to school. So, if he's happy, if his camper happy, then maybe we should leave it alone.
Exactly. And Tony Ball's right. I think this guy could just find levels. Just keep finding levels.
We need to see him in a situation like where he's struggling to win a fight.
Yeah.
Then maybe he'll bring out the stuff that we're asking for.
Little burst there from Brunca, but he was immediately punished for it.
But there you go, he's got him on the back foot. This is what I've been waiting to see. To see what he can do. The body weight forward, more power in the punches, see if he can put a dent in this fella now.
Oh, this is a spike in the body shot there, that left to the body. And this might be the exclamation mark we've been looking for Lee Selby. That left hook to the body has really hurt Brunca. Of this level, and Selby catching him with a big right hand, and Brunca soaking it all up, but he's getting marked around the eyes now.
I mean, it's though he doesn't realise that he's just moved into range. He likes to get his feet close and let the punches go, but that's not working, so he's going to have to let the punches go a little bit earlier than he's doing. But as I said earlier, if he changes, I get the feeling so would Lee Selby. Just looking so comfortable.
Brunca, when he has landed cleanly, and it's been the odd clean shot, so we don't seem to bother it at all. And they talk in the Tony Borg gym, I mean, the legendary stuff about how well he takes a punch. He said he's been hit by full-blown heavyweights. He said he didn't go down. He also said he'd forgotten where he parked the car after that. But he takes a shot, Lee Selby. But that's another point, Jim. He doesn't have to take many, does he? When do you see Selby take full-blooded punches? His defences are really good.
Yeah, and his reflexes too, but this is what he enjoys. He enjoys putting on a boxing exhibition. And some of the people who complain about him, you know, they want to see more drama. They reckon he's capable of it. I do too. He punches harder than he's shown us so far. But a couple of times he's landed cleanly, you can see he's quite keen. I think he would quite like to make a statement here. And I think he would like the stoppage, so when he starts landing, you know, regularly, then we'll maybe see him put more spite into the punches.
Again, making Brunca miss horribly. Brunca just plodding forward, but every time he gets close, you just sense he's got into Selby's range. And the Welshman can pick him off as he wants, like that. And they're talking animatedly in the corner.
I wonder if Selby will decide sooner or later that he wants to start taking it to Brunca. I mean, I really feel if he starts pushing Brunca back, he'll take everything away from him. This is a young man who has to be coming forward to do anything effectively. So I wonder if Lee Selby will start taking it to him, drive him back with a jab. No signs. He's just so happy. I mean, he's so comfortable at the moment. And a final eliminator, I might add.
Yeah, he's laughing, isn't he? Well, Anthony Joshua, the big fella, is due up next, the heavyweight. He smiles, he's relaxed. He's the coolest man on the planet. He really is. You wouldn't know he's in for a big fight tonight.
You ready?
Anthony, a year on from your professional debut in the same arena, in the same dressing room. How do the feelings compare to that night?
It was a lot different. It was my pro debut. I was out of the ring for about 15 to 16 months, you know, making a decision to turn pro, training up for the pro debut. Now, I've been busy. I've been out 8 times this year. I'm feeling confident and relaxed, but I'm humble, I respect my opponent, I know he's dangerous, and I've got a tough job to do at hand in about an hour's time.
He's not been stopped since 2005. Do you think you can be the man to stop him tonight?
That's not really my main aim. My main aim is to go out there and do a job and get the win. There's a WBC international title on the line, and that's my main aim, is to win that. If the stoppage comes, that's a bonus, and that's a compliment of the training that I've been doing, my strength conditioning coach and my trainer in the gym. So we'll see what happens, but that's not the main aim. A knockout isn't.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Mr. Cool, He'll be on next as soon as Lee Selby has dealt with Joel Brunker, because that's what we're looking at, Jim. It's just a question of whether Selby can go through the gears, get this fella out of there, whether Brunker can stick around for 12 rounds, but certainly through the first four, it's been a gulf in class between the two in terms of talent and technique. Selby again just teeing off pretty much as he wants.
A bit more spite in those punches from Selby. I wonder maybe if he's thinking, I mean, really, stand your ground, don't allow this fellow to march forward. But the trouble, I think Lee enjoys what he's doing here. I think he actually enjoys putting on a boxing exhibition. You know, most boxing fans want the drama. He's capable of it. So I'm hoping sooner or later he'll stand his ground, take it to Brunker, and I wonder if he can get him out of there.
I think he's having a much easier night than he was expecting.
Step away. There you go. Step out.
Well, there he is. I mean, this is what happened against Randall Monroe. He was quite happy to box at a distance. Then a couple of times he pinned Randall in the corner, let the punches go. So first little signs
of
that.
Beautiful.
Now.
He's took it very well, though, Brunker. Oh, just teed it up there. That sneaky right hand, and followed up with a hook.
You know, I'm just thinking, Nick, we're saying we want this, we want that. When Floyd Mayweather does stuff like this, we're raving about it. Well, that was pure class.
Well, they call him the Welsh Mayweather, don't they? You can see why. Caught him within a little counter there, and then just decided to hold. Again, that two-punch combination, that hook downstairs, the left hook upstairs.
The referee shouldn't allow him to place one hand on the opponent before he, while he tees up the other one. But I think Marcus McDonald's just letting things flow, which is good. But there are times when he actually lays the leading hand on Brunker, then throws the right.
Well, he boxed a WBC eliminator, didn't he, last time we saw him against that Mexican, Carcicha, who didn't offer an awful lot and didn't have a lot on his card. You're wondering what he was doing, quite frankly, in an eliminator. Brunker deserves his shot, but Selby is making him look very ordinary indeed.
Break, stop boxing! Step away, both of you.
I'm just wondering what they tell the Brunker when he goes back to the corner. I don't fancy the job, because I wouldn't know what to tell him.
Well, I said at the end of the first round, Jim, he needs a plan B. He ain't got one.
No.
Sport.
Saying you've got to throw him all punches. I mean, yeah. Also that.
So, what you got to miss with more punches. I think that's the result of that. The kid is simply not good enough. Selby is class. He is looking genuine world class. Brunker has never been anyone in with anyone as good as this.
Round six then, it is a 12-rounder. Selby not yet out of second.